Hello everybody! That's a rather sad sight, isn't it? After a summer where we should have had blockbuster releases of action, adventure, superheroes, romance, nothing. And now the cinemas have had to close their doors and are in crisis. They need their own superhero to save the day. So, ladies and gentlemen, I can reveal to you exclusively that I am Cinema Man. Stephen, how many times have I told you not to call me at... Oh. Really? Cinema Man? And John's had a quad bike accident? You'd like me to do the music? There's no budget, but it'll be a great credit and good for my career. I've never heard that before. Yes, of course I'll do it. Team, to the shed!
Okay. Right. So we got the brief from Stephen, and now we've got a rough piece of movie, some of which you've seen, but we're going to have a look through. What I'm going to do, let me just give you an outline of what's going to happen over the course of this little film. We're going to take a quick look, a very brief overview of Junkie XL Brass, which is the library which we're going to use to write the superhero theme. Then we're going to look at the movie and try and take it seriously and sort of spot it, if you see what I mean, and come and talk through what we're trying to do. Then we're going to write the tune. Then we're going to write the backing track. And then finally we add the brass back in and the rest of it. Now, there's quite a lot going on in this movie. And so if you look underneath and you mouse over the just at the bottom of this window in YouTube, you'll see a sort of index. So you can actually skip about. So if you don't particularly want to watch one bit of it, you want to watch another bit again or whatever, that's how you do it. What more could you possibly want? No, you can't have a Range Rover and world peace. Never mind. Okay, so look, let's start by having a quick look at Junkie XL Brass, because this is an interesting library. It's a fairly significant release for Orchestral Tools, who made it. When I first got it, when I first heard about it, I thought, what else is there to say in the world of orchestral brass? Have we not, we got Berlin Brass, we got Sydney Brass, we got Spitfire Brass, we got Hollywood Brass. What could Junkie XL bring to the party which isn't already on the table? And when I was first looking at it, I thought, oh, okay, yeah, it's perfectly nice and all the rest of it, but it really comes into its own. You may notice when you start looking at this, it sort of does things. Look, you've got 12 horns. You have 12 trombones. 12 trombones? Tom, what were you thinking? That must be every trombonist in wherever they recorded it. No, there must be more than that. Anyway, but the point is, what it's really good at is stepping up and doing those big sounds, but it doesn't sound overblown and kind of phasey and a bit weird, which is sometimes the fate of some of these libraries when they try and put too many instruments on. It doesn't get bigger, it just gets sort of weirdly smaller. We could spend quite a lot of time talking about the sign player, which is the brand new player from Orchestral Tools, and I really rather like it. I think it's good. Let's try. Okay, you want to hear the 12 horns? Okay, I'll play you the 12 horns, and it goes like this. It's really got a top gear. It's kind of good. When you, some libraries you get to sort of, in a big, busy arrangement, you need that extra, and you can't quite get there, and you go, please play louder, but you can't because they played louder a long time ago. This one they do, and it really cuts through. As we'll see later, when we get into the heavy scoring part of the thing, Okay, you want to hear what 12 trombones sound like? Yeah, let's do that. Let's try the shorts, shall we? And also I can then tell you how this... look, you see, it's the nice thing about sign player, you can load up a whole lot of stuff. There's tons to say about this player, because it is really good. That's the MIDI channel, so I can change it back to one, and then you can have... That's what 12 trombone sounds like playing staccato. This is very much a professional library and priced accordingly. So it is not something which you're going to pick up super cheap. It's going to cost quite a lot of money, but what if you are doing this for a living in particular, and this is the kind of thing you do, which is what I spent quite a lot of my professional life doing, this answers a need. Right. We'll come back to that later in this epic superhero special. What about our superhero? We left him just about to take off and all that kind of thing. Right, what we're now going to do is a bit of spotting, so to speak. What we're going to do is look at the movie as it stands and talk through exactly how we're going to score it. So let's just have a little...
Hello, everybody.
Oh, this is so weird.
That's a rather sad sight, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
After a summer where we should have had...
What? You standing in front of a green screen. Yeah, that's pretty
adventure,
sad.
Superheroes, romance, nothing.
Okay.
And now the cinemas have had to close their doors and are in crisis.
Where is the music coming in?
They need their own superhero to save the day.
Mm-hmm.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I can reveal to you exclusively that I am Cinema Man.
And here he goes, and he takes off. Right. So now, the thing about this is, okay, there is a clear sort of pastiche comedy thing going on here, and it's not taking itself very seriously. The worst thing you could possibly do in this sequence is to try and score it as comedy, because the comedy comes from taking it seriously. So if you're writing the music for this, you have to write serious superhero music, and then it becomes funny. As soon as you try and write it as a send-up, it's not going to work. And so as he, even when Hugh the editor starts messing about, as he did, we treat it seriously and then it remains funny. And then it ends as, that's not me, but it's going to end with me waking up in bed and it's all some weird dream. Or nightmare. Probably nightmare. This is definitely a good idea. Okay, so we're going to take this seriously, but equally, there is obviously a sort of Superman thing going on here. You know, the colours and the whole... So, you know, any reference you should make remotely to John Williams' Superman theme is definitely a very, very, very bad idea. Because, as we know, John Williams' lawyers are really good. And if you combine something which sounds like the theme with pictures which are also sort of intimating towards that, you're dead in the water. So don't, and also it wouldn't, that's not what we want to do. To take it seriously means to write something which is a classic superhero theme, but also something which has something of now. So you, it's a retro modern thing, okay? So where are we going to start with this retro modern extravaganza? I tend to have an approach when it comes to superhero things, because I've done a couple, what I tend to do is to start with a kind of a sort of rhythmic ostinato of some description, so a rhythmic motif, and then I can build on that, and I don't really think too much about the chord progression to start with, and then come up with the top line, the actual theme itself. And then I start the conversation between the theme and the chord progression to make things move about. So that's kind of the process we're going to go through. But ultimately, there's no getting away from the fact that sooner or later, I'm going to have to write a tune. And it needs to be a reasonably good one. I've had, I've been messing about with some ideas and I haven't quite got there yet, to be honest. Well, you want me to tell you what's really going on, don't you? Okay, so where we started out, where did I start out? I got this idea which I quite like. I quite like a very dry sort of timpani thing going on, which I quite like. I think it's quite an interesting idea. And here, let me just have a listen. I can't quite remember how this... Oh my Lord, that's loud. Shall we turn that down a bit? See, I quite like that. That wasn't actually where I completely started. Where would I, let me just find the one where I completely started. But I tend to mess about with things like that until I get something which I can start building ideas around. And I think a distinctive rhythmic thing going on underneath it is a good place to start. Let me see if this one is any earlier in my idea tree. Maybe let's have a little listen. Yeah. Now, the only trouble with that, it's 7/8, which I mean, effectively, so it's 4/4 and 3/4, so it makes 7/8. You know, and that's great. It's got that slightly offbeat thing, which I quite like. It's very sort of melded into this minor key, and I want something which is not. Here we go. So here's a. It's just not doing it for me. You need, remember the pictures, I haven't got the pictures up in this particular example, but the pictures are important because it reminds you, well, except there's contrast between what's going on in the picture and what we're actually writing, because we're trying to take this seriously. But there is something celebratory about Cinema Man. He is like Captain America in the Marvel universe, because he's sort of all kind of goody two-shoes and a bit sort of spanky, and that actually makes him quite hard to score. What you really want is conflicted and dark and all the rest of it, because that's much easier to write music about than hi, I'm the all-American guy. Really? Oh, okay, if you say so. You're my favorite character to write music about. No, you want dark and conflicted, like me. No, obviously not. Okay, so look, enough of this. Let's get into what is called here. Oh, well, did I do a 3/4 version as well? I think I might have done a 3/4 version. Let's see what happens. A trip down memory lane. I was doing this a couple of days ago, and then I ran out of time. But this is not the worst thing that can happen, actually, because you have little ideas, and you come back and listen to them and go, that's a super-duper idea. Or you think you've had the best idea in the world, and you go, not your best idea. Sorry, mate. Back to the drawing board. You know what that feels like, don't you? I know. Okay, so let's see how this one shakes out in 3/4. This is lacking urgency. This is nothing like urgent enough. No energy. Nope. Sorry. Off you go, mate. You can sit, you can stand there looking, you know, all belligerent in front of that Cineworld. But it's not going to do you any good at all, because we're going to load up where we finally ended up with this backing track. Okay, so is this going to be any good? Shall we find out? Yep. Oh, bit of damage going. I quite like this. Now, let's look at it with the... This is before we've gone anywhere near a tune. Fits. Why am I waving at horses? Bit of falling. Sunglasses are out, pulled out. Yeah, too right, mate. Weird piece of library footage. Okay, I quite like that. I do quite like that. I think that, you know, it's got something going for it, which is kind of... But we now need to come up with the proverbial tune. I've put this moment off. I've had a couple of little ideas. I tell you what. We're going to get up a piano. Any old piano, because it's a sort of vanilla thing. As long as you don't get locked into it. Oh, where's my piano gone? Oh, it's down here. No, it's not. Have I locked? Oh, synth. There we go. It's in other, I think. There we go.
Other.
It's not other, it's a piano. Welcome. This is a fairly typical kind of minor one, sharp five, major four, that chord progression, C minor, A flat, major, F major, crops up an awful lot. I've used it a few times, actually, more than once or twice. So, want to buy a second-hand chord progression? You know, only six careful owners. So that's not going to do it. No, I don't like that chord progression. You know, it's not to say none of these things work, because we've had this conversation before. It's just, this is where tunes are going through the filter of what I, you know, my kind of brain and what I like and what I don't like. And that's how it's not just a random tune. It turns into my tune. And, you know, because ultimately what I like and what I don't like is what is going to turn this idea into something worth listening to or not. Okay. This is hard. This is really hard. I'm sitting here thinking about how to write a tune, you know, and I just got to, as you can probably tell by the look of panic in my eyes, this is not one where I'm going to say, here's one I came up with earlier, and roll out some perfect little theme. Okay, look, you need to go and get yourself a quick cup of tea, because we're going to be back in a moment with more stuff. And important things will happen. Ah, you say what? You haven't yet subscribed to this channel? If you're not a regular visitor, please subscribe, because then when we do spontaneous live things and all kind of stuff, then you'll find out, rather than finding out after it's all over, which isn't quite so much fun. Okay, I'll be back in a minute, and we'll nail this superhero thing if it kills me. See you in a bit. Okay, I've done a few moments of faffing. The way I do. I've been trying to work out whether this should go quickly, like, or slowly. You see, if I do it quickly, there's lots of room for counterpuntal things going on. So this patch here is... which one am I using? I'm using the 12 horns, you know, the big one. When you start hearing this get more full, this little arrangement, you'll see why this library really works. Why can't I play this quickly? Come on, Guy, you've decided to play it quickly. Do, 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 do. That's better. Whoa. Better, he says?
Just before he crashes and burns.
Yeah, that's what just happened. Well, sort of. And look, you know, some people said, you know, can we have a day in the life of film composer? You're what? Just extend what you're watching now to 13 or 14 hours, and you get the gist of how a day in the life of a film composer goes. You know, there used to be this thing quite recently where people were really into what they call slow TV, where you watched sort of 16 elderly Norwegians knitting for a day. That is what a day in the life of a film composer is like, in reality. I'm told it's a really funny film by Bear McCreary, where he takes the mickey and, you know, does it in a really hilarious sort of way. That is really funny, but it's not how it really is. It's quite dull to watch. And believe me, I say that because my various other assistants and family and people who have to sit outside and listen to this distantly, hearing the same theme go round and round and round and round. It's enough to drive you to distraction. What we got going here? We've got chamber strings, but not just any old chamber strings. We've got chamber strings with the close mics turned on. That's with them off. Get a bit of added edge. I often put solo strings over the top as well. So where are we going to start this? Now we've got to start thinking about how we're scoring this. Well, I thought you promised me a chord progression. That's not a chord progression, that's just an open fifth. Okay, okay. I appreciate your point of view. Not. Dun, dun, dun. It's all... somebody said, why don't you use track delay to move it around? Because as you change tempo and you change... Sometimes track delay is a bit of a sort of blunt instrument. And it doesn't... It all looks right... And if you're adjusting the timing in two different places, I just prefer to slide it about. There's no right or wrong answer. You can do what you like. But I like to have total control over this better. Let's sound it, see if it sounds in time. Actually, that's quite good. Do you know what? Maybe I'll add another layer in. Okay, I quite like this now. And what this needs is boom, boom, boom. It needs some da-da-dum, da-da-da-da-dum, or whatevers. So we need some... Ooh, look. What have I played in here? It doesn't matter. I'm not going to play. Okay, maybe I wasn't. No. This takeoff's going to need a bit more than that. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is let's quantize this and make sure it's in time. Not quite. And then I'm going to, once I've got my little rhythmic pattern going, I'm then going to dupe it. Then this can be a template for the other bits we put on. Okay. Okay, now let's rock and roll here. Let me take that off the the Juni thing, the synth. We're going to render out. There comes a point when I'm doing these scoring things where I start speeding up. You'll be relieved to hear that that moment has now arrived, because as you might have noticed, it's pitch dark outside, and it's time I got on with this. Let's jump in here. Where's my trombones? Right, let's have a look at the mixer. Where's the mixer gone? There it is. Here's the mixer. It's laid out in a really clever way. Each of them, you see, you can load up all these different articulations and all these different instruments down the side, and you get all the mixer, all the mics for the horns. Then scroll along, you get all the mics for the trumpets, and then all the mics for the trombones. So if we want to put some close in and take the tree down a bit from the trombones so we get that crisp sound, that's how you do it. I'm pretty impressed with that. I like that a lot. Right, so now I need to chop this, because we're going to use that one, because that one is working. Cooking with the proverbial gas. And then we can just drop it in where we need it. Duck-a-duck-a-dum. Okay, so we need a duck-a-duck-a-dum there. Where are these? Okay, now, show and hide. There we go, nice button, this one. You have to go into the key thing to program that, but it's allows you just to see the tracks which are being used. Okay. Okay. Next up, duplicate track, bring our friend back. Because in reality, these are quite low, and at the moment we're only using tenor trombones. Now the world is full of bass trombone as well, so I'm going to put those in and put them down the bottom. And you notice it automatically maps the key switches to G6, so it's right up to the left, because there's not going to be any room down the bottom. Right, so we're going to mouse those together, and we're going to take out the top voice of this and see what this sounds like with the bass trombones. Okay, that's all right. But once again, if we just leave that mix as it is, it's not going to sound as crisp as it should. And when we go in, we go along, we mix along again. Come on, get hold of it. That's it, you got it. Bass trombones, we want a close mic in there. Bass trombones, we're going to take the tree down a bit so it's a bit more. There you go, that's better. Got a little bit more oomph, crackle. Let's see what that sounds like. Okay, that's good. Yep, this is starting to work. About this stage in the game, I would often probably knock it off and come back tomorrow, because we're getting into detail, and sometimes when you get into the detail, you miss the big picture and you miss the fact that you've done something which isn't good or whatever. So it's getting there. It's not there yet, obviously, but the basic idea is working. But you see the way that the sort of ideas bounce off each other, and then you see one's bad and one's good, and then the amount of faffing you have to do inside, you know, to line things up and make it sound like they're all in the room. But I have to say, so far, I'm really impressed with the Junkie XL Brass, Tom's Brass Library, which is, it's very powerful, and it's because it sits inside a big arrangement really well, and it cuts through. This is definitely the right library for this occasion, but I have yet to rise to the occasion completely, because we've got a way to go yet. So look, I'm going to come back with the last part of this, where we're going to finish this epic piece off. I'm going to do some more, then I'll bring you back, and then we'll sort of talk it through, okay? But so I will see you tomorrow. Another day, another cup of tea. Right. I spent another probably half an hour on this now and added extra couple of little touches here and there, things like that. You can see I've got big headphones on today.
Big headphones.
And so let me just show you how it's gone together so far, and then you can tell me whether you like it or not. The library sounding absolutely great. It really, when the bigger and the more complicated this arrangement gets, and it's got a long way to go yet, it needs a lot of tidying up. But let's just walk this through, shall we? So that you can see what's going on. Let me move myself to the side for the moment. Okay, so let me just bring this in, because what we've now got going is...
Just save the day. So, ladies and gentlemen...
So as I start to introduce Cinema Man, I go, ladies and gentlemen, in comes the percussion first of all. So first of all, we're going to bring in the percussion. Then when I start running towards the camera, we bring in the synth and the string ostinato. And then the theme comes in as I take off. Okay, watch this again.
Just save the day. So, ladies and gentlemen, I can reveal to you exclusively that I am Cinema Man.
Right, now we're into the tune. Okay, right. Let me actually just solo up the brass, because there's a lot going on in here now. But as I said, I mean, I could spend a great deal longer making this sound really cool, because actually there's tons of power in here, tons and tons of power in here to do this properly. And there we go. So we've got the first thing you hear is the that's a staccatissimo trombone 12s with a bass trombone on the bottom and a cimbasso going boom on the bottom. Then we get the horns. And there's a little counter melody going in here, which is high. Actually, it's a bit quiet at the moment. Let me see if I can bring it up a bit. Using my mod wheel. There we go. So we're going in here with my pencil, lifting it just a touch. I don't want to go too much on the first one. Maybe I can put that a bit more on the stop. That's a bit better. You see, what I should really do is add something slightly firmer, like a moccato on the first note. Now, from this second time round, we put the trumpets playing a unison with an octave above the horn. So you go. And the counter melody passes to trombones when that's playing the legato trombone. Right, so there's lots and lots. It's a very, very good sound. It's and you right at the start of this epic video, you remember I said, you know, straight out of the package, you think, yeah, it's great, you know, it's really well done and all the rest of it, but why is it different? When you then put in, or when you put in the rest of the arrangement, suddenly you then go, ah, okay, how am I going to get something which is going to cut through this lot? And that is the answer as to why this is different, because this does. I think I'm now done. Let's have a look at how the whole thing comes together. Arrangements like, and this is not particularly big, there's not much going on here yet, but there's quite a lot of layers, and it will take quite a bit of mixing properly to get them all to... It's hard stuff to mix this, but bear with me that this is sort of sketch Mark II type thing rather than a finished product. But give it a listen and see what you think as we introduce the world to Cinema Man. Speak up, Guy. Introduce the world to Cinema Man and then you haven't got anything to say for yourself. That's unusual. Right, here we go. Cinema Man.
Save the day. So, ladies and gentlemen, I can reveal to you exclusively that I am Cinema Man. The day.
Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Okay, I think we're done. I think that will do. So, conclusions about the library. It's a very, very well done piece of work. I really like it. It's able to do two things which are really complicated. Sound really big and really loud, but without sounding all kind of slightly weird and phasey. Brass is the hardest by far, I think, of all the sections of the orchestra to try and sample, and they've done an outstandingly good job. There aren't any crescendos or swells in here, and there aren't any time-synced double tongues and triple tongues, and I think that would be a really great addition. I don't think a library like this is going to need muted brass, because it's all about... rather than but it does do quite well as well, so you know, but it is professionally priced, best part of €1,000, so you probably need a significant amount of kit to for it really to earn its keep, and particularly if you're working professionally, it's fine, it's obviously a no-brainer, but for those who are doing this as a serious hobby, it's a little bit more. Now, but all that said, you can buy it instrument by instrument, and that is a lot more affordable. So if you just want that big killer 12-horn sound, you can buy it by itself. And that is probably, I would imagine, how the majority of people will enjoy this library. Let's just talk through the other part of what we've been doing today, which is the superhero thing. So when we were commissioned to do this by Steven Spielberg all that time ago, it's clear it's a sort of adventure comedy, and the only way to reinforce the comedy is to take it absolutely seriously and score it as if it was Superman, you know, 2020, which is sort of more or less what we've done. Equally, we don't want it to sound entirely like Superman 1980s. We want it to have an element of that, which it has in the brass, in the tune, and the sort of horn passages, but that kind, that percussive synthy string ostinato percussive background gives it a slightly more modern feel, which I rather like. So then the process is, for me, I try and get this rhythmic thing going, so I've got a kind of rhythmic bed to put my tune on. Then I go to town on the tune, and I keep tweaking away until I really feel I've got somewhere. And I've got something which I can meld into a number of different shapes. And that's what I've got here. So it's, if this was a real gig, I'd say, yeah, demo one, go away, think about it for a day, come back and do demo two and three and four. And eventually, out of all this will come something which you hopefully will feel has totally nailed it. So that's all I have for you for today. It's been a bit of an epic. I'm sorry it's gone on so long. But please, if you've enjoyed this, remember to subscribe, because that's what, you know, then you get notified when this happens, and particularly when we do lives. If you don't subscribe, you won't know when we're doing a live thing. So anyway, that's it from me. Hope you've enjoyed it. See you very soon. Bye-bye.